on top of being an incredible player for the Halifax Thunderbirds, you're also a teacher. So can you just tell us a little bit about what you teach?
So I teach high school math right now. It's I teach all grades. So I teach 9, 10, 11, and then I teach grade 12 data management.
You've been playing in this league for some time, so I'm sure a lot of guys look to you as a leader on the team. And do you kind of find yourself like falling into teaching habits around your teammates, particularly the younger ones?
Yes, at times. I do find myself teaching like our systems, how we want to think as a defensive unit, because the biggest thing is defense is being able to work together and be on the same page. So a lot of it is teaching some of that to the young guys, getting them up to speed, but at the same time, they're teaching and giving different perspectives on what they've learned through their lacrosse career. And it's not just me, it's very back and forth and open conversation. So we're always open to different perspectives on things and being able to learn where we can.
Have you had any, you know, virtual teaching struggles or any like Zoom call struggles trying to get through to these students through a computer screen?
There's a bit of a learning curve, but I think the kind of the funniest mess ups have been when we're doing remote practices as well, because I'm coaching as well. And it's been when the dogs have been outside and they've kind of gotten in my way while I'm trying to run through a drill, and they've been trying to play with me and kind of bumping into me while I'm trying to demonstrate a drill or whatnot.
Oh, they think it's playtime, not practice time.
Yes. Yep. They're trying to in there and play.
So what's harder, like in terms of teaching virtually, teaching math or teaching lacrosse?
I think they both have their own challenges in different ways. Like lacrosse, not everyone has access to a net or a wall that you can throw. So we've had to come up with a few different creative ideas that allow everyone to participate, be able to still develop some of our basic skills and work that way.
All right. Well, before I let you go, is there anything else that you want to say, particularly related to our EDUCAP initiative?
I find, like anything else, it's trying to find that routine. Once you get in that routine, you can kind of keep yourself steady and be able to stay on top of your work, your workouts, and balance everything that's going on right now, especially when you have what seems like a lot of free times. If you schedule it, you can stay organized and stay on top of things and accomplish different tasks throughout the day.